the measurement of that operator, then we will say that they are the non-commuting operators. When the measurement of one operator earlier is not disturbing the measurement of the second operator, we say that they are commuting operators. And here we will have to verify that what is the X and P relation, whether they are commuting operators or they are non-commuting operators. So we will have to check. In order to check this thing, we will apply this on a function, and function will be a function of x. So x in p, if I apply on a function f of x, then I will have to see here as well that x p and f of x, so I will not write f of x but is short f minus p x and f. Now this thing is equal x, and then for p I can write this operator. So this is minus I h bar, and d by dx, d by dx of f minus minus I h bar and d by dx of x and f. Now here this thing is minus I h bar because it's a constant and it is coming out, then x in df over dx means the derivative of f with respect to x, and then plus I h bar, and now d by dx will actually operate on x and f. X is itself x and f is a function of x. So we will have to utilize the product rule, first function into derivative of the second function plus second function into derivative of the first function. So here we will have minus I h bar x and df over dx, and here it will be plus I h bar x df over dx. So it means these two are actually cancelling, and we are left, this one is going to 1. So only f remains here, and this is equal to I h bar f. So just comparing with this one, this is f of x. So removing the test function f of x, we are having that x in p commutation relation is equal to I h bar. So this thing is equal to I h bar, and it means that non-zero nature of this means that these are the non-commuting operators. The measurement of this one first disturbs the system for the measurement of this operator, and this is, that's why equal to non-zero, and we have this equal to I h bar. So we will write here I h bar, that this thing is equal to I h bar. So let me write this thing here, that so we can write that a minus a plus is equal to this from here, and as we have done here, that this is actually the Hamiltonian operated on psi is equal to E psi. So our Hamiltonian is equal to this. I can write this, that A minus A plus is equal to 1 over 2m and P square plus m square omega square x square plus, this is m h bar omega. So this will be m h bar omega, and here we will have 2m h bar omega here. So this one from here I can write, here is h bar omega as well. Now this thing is actually our Hamiltonian. So this a minus a plus is equal to Hamiltonian divided by h bar omega, plus this m h bar omega is gone with this, and I can write this one is half. So we have proved this thing that a minus a plus is h divided by h bar omega plus half. Similarly, we can prove this thing as well, that what about a plus when multiplied with a minus? So we will write here, a minus and a plus was like this. Now a plus will be earlier, a minus will be later. So this one will be early and this one will be later. Similarly, we will go on with this procedure, and the only difference that will occur will actually be here, that this will be plus and this will be px minus xp. So this will give us that a, this will be, means just following this way you can do is as an exercise, a very simple and short exercise, that xp is equal to ih bar. If I reverse their order and write px, then this will be equal to minus ih bar. If I do all the practice here, then I will come to know that this one is with a minus sign. So px will be minus ih bar, and here after doing the calculations here, this will be h over h bar omega minus half. So this way we will prove this one as well. And now we can prove this commutation relation. If we are given an exercise like, what is the commutation of a minus with a plus, then from here, from any commutation relation, we can write that this is equal to a minus a plus minus a plus a minus. Now we have written here that a minus a plus is h over h bar omega plus half, and then minus a plus a minus is minus h bar omega. So this is h over h bar omega, and minus minus will become plus, and it will be half. So these two are cancelling, and half plus half is equal to 1. So I can write that the commutation relation a minus with a plus is equal to 1. And that's the benefit of using the h bar omega over here, which we used for convenience. If we don't use h bar omega there, then a minus a plus will be equal to h bar omega. So it is only for a convenience. Similarly, if I write a minus a plus first and then a minus, then this will be equal to minus 1. Just write this early and this later, then it will be minus half, and it will be equal to minus 1. So this way we can prove this relation. So far we have derived that A minus A plus is equal to H over H bar omega plus half, and similarly A plus A minus is equal to H over H bar omega minus half. We have also derived that the commutation of A minus and A plus with each other is equal to 1, which is equal to A minus A plus minus A plus A minus is equal to 1. So we have derived these things so far. Now from here I can write the Hamiltonian in this way as well, that A minus A plus A minus A plus, and when this half goes here then it will become minus half, and when this is multiplied with H bar omega then it will be equal to H. So H is equal to this, or I can write that this H is equal from this equation, that this is H bar omega and A plus A minus and plus half. So I can write H both ways. When to remember this, when we write A plus earlier, then we will have to write plus half. When we write A minus earlier, we will have to write A minus. So I can write that the equation H psi equals E psi. Then from this equation, I can write that H bar omega means it is just another representation of writing the Hamiltonian H bar omega in A minus A plus, then minus half of psi is equal E psi. Or I can write that H bar omega, A plus earlier, A minus later, so I will write plus here, and psi equals E psi. Now there is a crucial step, and the crucial step is, let me underline this. So the crucial step is, if psi satisfies the Schrodinger equation with energy E. So I can write that when H psi is equal to E psi, or I can say this, when psi satisfies the Schrodinger equation with energy E, then A plus psi will satisfy the Schrodinger equation. If I apply Hamiltonian on this, then it will satisfy this with E plus H bar omega, and then A plus psi. So means for this wave function, when Hamiltonian operates on this, it gives energy E psi. When a wave function is A plus psi, then it will give energy E plus H bar omega, and then the wave function, and we will have to prove this thing. So to prove this, we start with this side. So let's start, apply Hamiltonian on A plus psi. So the Hamiltonian we have written here, we can write the Hamiltonian like this or like this. So it's up to us that what we write, what we select. So let me select this one. So the Hamiltonian is equal to H bar omega, and then A plus A minus plus half. This is the value of the Hamiltonian, and then this is A plus psi, A plus psi. So this thing is equal to, this thing is equal to H bar omega, and now apply it on this. So I can write that A plus A minus, then A plus psi plus half, and A plus